Hello everyone. Today, we'll explore the derivative of the arctangent function. If y is arctangent x, we can interchange the positions of x and y to obtain the original function x equals tangent y. The derivative we are looking for, dy by dx, can be expressed as 1 over dx over dy. Let's differentiate tangent y with respect to y and substitute the result into the expression on the right. The derivative of tangent y with respect to y is secant squared y, and when we substitute this into the expression on the right, we get dy by dx is 1 over secant squared y. Since secant is reciprocal of cosine, we can simplify this to cosine squared y. As dy by dx currently expressed as a function of y, let's transform it into a function of x. To do this, let's draw a right angle triangle and examine the relationships. Using tangent y as x, we express the right side x as x over 1. Drawing the right angle triangle with the angle y, the opposite side as x and the adjacent side is 1, and we can apply the Pythagorean theorem. The hypotenuse is then square root 1 plus x squared. Using this right angle triangle, we can find cosine y as 1 over square root 1 plus x squared, and it's a square, cosine squared y becomes 1 over 1 plus x squared. If we substitute this result into the dy by dx expression above, dy by dx simplifies to 1 over 1 plus x squared. Now, we have straightforwardly found the derivative of arctangent x. Next, we'll use this result to demonstrate a method for differentiating and integrating more easily and quickly. To illustrate how this method is developed, we'll differentiate arctangent box using the chain rule. Let's start by assuming y equals arctangent box, and we want to find dy by dx. If we denote box as u, then y equals arctangent box becomes y equals arctangent u. And using the chain rule, dy by dx is expressed as dy by du times du over dx. To find dy by dx, we need to determine dy by du inside the green box and du over dx inside the blue box, which we refer to as 1 and 2 respectively. Since we've substituted the box with u, y is arctangent u. And for 1, the derivative of dy by du is found to be 1 over 1 plus u squared, which becomes 1 over 1 plus box squared after substituting u back with box. Now, for 2, du over dx is simply the derivative of box with respect to x, denoted as d box over dx. When you multiply 1 and 2, we get 1 over 1 plus box squared times d box over dx. Simplifying further, the derivative of the arctangent box is box prime over 1 plus box squared. In essence, when finding the derivative of the arctangent box, you examine the contents inside the box. Place the derivatives of the terms inside the box in the numerator and position 1 plus box squared in the denominator. Shall we work on an example together? Here, we have y equals arctangent 3x squared plus 11x. As you can see, the contents inside the box are 3x squared plus 11x. Since dy by dx is box prime over 1 plus box squared, and we know what's inside the box, and we can directly substitute the box prime with 6x plus 11, and the box in the denominator with 3x squared plus 11x, giving us dy by dx is 6x plus 11 all over 1 plus 3x squared plus 11x squared. How about that? We found the answer in just one line. Let's summarize. The derivative of the arctangent box is box prime over 1 plus box squared. Now, what would be the integral of box prime over 1 plus box squared? It would be arctangent box plus the constant of integration c. Here is an example. The integral of 1 over x times 1 plus ln x squared. We can easily find the answer by comparing what is a box and what is a box prime in the formula above. By moving the x in the denominator to the numerator, the expression becomes the integral of 1 over x over 1 plus ln x squared. Looking closely at this fraction, we can identify that the box is ln x and the numerator's 1 over x is box prime. So the answer to this problem is easily found as arctangent ln x plus c. How about that? We found the answer in just one line again. If you want to see more examples and detailed explanations, check the link in the upper right corner. Various examples are prepared. Today, we examined the derivative of the inverse tangent function and also explored a quick way to integrate. I hope today's video was helpful for your learning. Thank you to all of you who are watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and hit the like button. Have a great day, and until next time, this has been your math guardian, Alex.